What was your vibe been since coming out of the jungle?
Do you know what? It's kind of been, like, a little bit institutionalised. You know, you come in, you go in and you're with these people who become your family. Mm. And, you know, we've got a WhatsApp group and we really miss each other and we're all meeting up tomorrow. I'll speak to Dennis every day. It's so funny because my daughter, she... when I spoke to her when I came out, she went, "Dad, I have got a million questions to ask you about I'm a Celebrity." So anyway, the next thing she goes, Dad, will you ring Dennis? Yeah. So I ring him, one of the nicest men you'll ever meet, by the way. So I ring him and I said, "Dennis, would you speak to my daughter?" Anyway, he spoke to her. And then the next day she went, "Dad, will you ring Dennis again?" So...
There she is,
a little dad.
So you've just been on the phone to Dennis since you left.
Well, yeah, basically. So I ring him, I said, "Dennis, do me a favour, mate." I said, "She's driving me up the wall. Will you just speak to her?" Anyway, she started crying. She went, "Can't believe you've embarrassed me, Dad."
In front of Dennis.
Yeah. So I went, "I think you love Dennis, don't you?"
And how is Polly doing?
Yeah, she's great. Jimmy,
because she wasn't very well for a few days that you were in the jungle, which, of course, you didn't know about.
No, she had croup, I think, so... but, yeah, she's fine. She's a little warrior.
Are you glad they didn't tell you?
Yeah. But, sure, I mean, you know, one of my close friends passed away the day that I went into the jungle. You know, he was a top man, and... they tried to contact me in the jungle, but because he wasn't immediate family, they can't let you know. And it's his funeral on Wednesday. Gary Lloyd, he was a great guy.
How did you find out, Jimmy?
Do you know how I found out? I came out of the jungle and they had this WhatsApp group called Gary Lloyd Tribute. And he was a bit of a wind-up, so I just thought, oh, it's just a wind-up. Anyway, these messages kept coming through and kept coming through. And I went on it and it's just like, it was heartbreaking, you know, and... I just started reading it, and it just dawned upon me what had happened, and it was just
had
horrible.
Had they been able to contact you, would you still have gone in and done the jungle?
Well, I mean, I can't answer that
difficult
question,
to
but
say,
you know,
isn't it?
But yeah,
it's like you say, Jimmy. When you're in there, you're in this bubble. There isn't any contact with the outside world, as much as people think you've got a sort of an easy ride in there. No. It really isn't. What we see on the telly is only a fraction of the intensity of it.
Of course, I mean, I dropped 1.5 stone in there. You know, I had one meal.
It was nine days.
Yeah,
it was really noticeable in you.
Yeah,
I mean, I watched nearly every night, and you could visibly see you shrinking.
Yeah, and do you know what? I could feel it. I could feel my face sucking in and sucking in, and
it was interesting, you know, as well, though, Jamie, when you... I was
great for the waistline,
though. I literally...
The jungle diet.
The night that you got... you had your chicken wings, didn't you?
Yeah.
And Toff had the burger. But it was afterwards where you both said all you could taste was salt.
Yeah.
Because you hadn't had salt or pepper or anything for all those...
Body's starved of it, you know, and sugar. And I mean, we literally have to boil our own water, don't you?
Yeah.
You know, and...
People, it tastes like that, the fire, doesn't it?
It tastes like the fire,
disgusting.
Yeah. It's horrible. And sometimes you have to drink it hot, don't you? Because it's like, just because you boil it and then you have to, you know, you might be going out and doing a trial and if that's all that's in the thing, you have to drink it and, you know, but it was definitely the best experience that I've ever
experienced.
Let's
get to the nitty-gritty a little bit because I'm just interesting. So when you say you're all really good mates, are you all really good mates? Because obviously there were some people... I want to know the gossip. So there were some people that, quite frankly, that caused a bit of tension.
Yeah,
like,
okay.
So there was this whole thing about the whole... I know you want to get over it. We don't want to talk about loads, but the bullying thing, all that was... I mean, what we saw to what you experienced, do you think
it's
weighs
nonsense.
Up?
It's absolute nonsense. I mean... You've seen an hour a day edited, you know. We're in there 24 hours a day. And people are entitled to have an opinion, you know, and it wasn't. And Ian's come out and rubbished the rumours.
Yeah.
And it's just, like, it needs to move on from that now.
Move on, yeah.
I mean, like, Becky and Amir and Dennis are three of the... And Ian are three of the nicest people you'll ever wish to meet. And, you know, I just wish it would go away now because bullying is such a strong word.
Yes.
If you look it up in the English dictionary, what it actually means... You know, people are entitled to have an opinion.
Ian said exactly that. He made a statement saying that there was no bullying going on whatsoever. He wants to quash the rumour once and for all. Bullying is a really serious thing, a huge word, and there was no bullying whatsoever.
There you go.
Yeah. Okay, well,
thank you.
Thank you.
It was interesting, though, Jamie, because I would have a bit of a chat with our audience before we come on the show, and every time I'd ask the audience during the whole series, I'd say, who do you love? And it was always you and Toph. From the very beginning, yeah. It was always you guys said, Toph and Jamie, and there you were in the final. Yeah. It was kind of almost expected for me, having watched you both.
I mean, I didn't know, because obviously you don't know how you're coming across or how it's being edited, or... But, you know, Toph was such a worthy winner. She, you know, she was... Tough, as I named her, and yeah, she did great, and you know, but everyone was a winner in my eyes, you know, and to go through that experience together as a group, you know, you just, unless you've done it, you can't explain you know, because it's difficult to explain, because you are all in it together, and you know, that group got on so well, you know, and yeah, just an amazing experience.
Well, you were great.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah, you were great. You were.